Welcome back to my channel. Jay Siemens here, and today we are going fishing for giant walleyes, but it's not a normal fishing day. This is Jay versus Clay. What is Jay versus Clay, you might ask? Well, it's a competition. It's head to head. It's me against my fishing YouTuber buddy, Clayton Schick. We both guided together up in Northern Saskatchewan. We've been friends for a long time, and now we like a little friendly competition. So here's the deal. We're fishing for 9 hours. It's gonna be combined inches of our five longest walleyes. We're gonna do a check-in after 2 hours and after 4 hours to know how the other guy's doing. And then it's gonna go silent. I'm not gonna find out who wins until I watch Clayton's video when it goes live. So it's just a good way for some friendly competition. It gets me fishing hard. Last one against Clayton, I lost. I got smoked on largies. On largies, which was a surprise. He got a buffalo bag of big largies. And yeah, I dropped the ball. But anyways, we're back, we're swinging. And I'm coming for him. So, I got an hour or two to rig. I gotta rig up some rods, get the boat all ready and organized, and we are fishing from noon till nine. We're at Manitou Weather Station Lodge, and it's home to some very big walleyes. But we're gonna start rigging. I did some pre-fish. I will link the pre-fish video below, and drop-shotting was the key for these finicky fish. So I'm gonna actually retie because my line's a little worn. We're gonna do a drop shot, a jig and a leech, and a slip float. I'll show you in depth what these rigs look like once I have them all tied up. All right, rig number one is ready. 7.5 foot medium light, 10 pound braid, 2500 size spinning reel. And we got a drop shot. Got like a wide gap hook there, which a beautiful leech is gonna hang off of. And then we got a couple, you know, probably 12 inches of line, and then a drop shot weight. So essentially what that does is that weight sits on the bottom and that leech just hangs perfectly above for fussy fish and for when I'm targeting them with my live scope and sharpshooting them, looking for individual fish that I'm trying to catch. It's a really good way to get in front of their face and it's a finesse technique. So this is a little bit heavier. I got 12 pound fluoro, which is definitely on the heavier side for a technique like this, but we're targeting big fish. We got some big ones in pre-fish. All right, rig number two, also on a medium light, 7.5. We got split shot and a hook. I've actually never done this for walleyes before, but I know for really finicky fish it can be good. Split shots, if that focuses, are just little crimp on weights there. And then same deal, similar hook, maybe one size smaller. This we're doing on 8 pound fluoro. So this is gonna be like if the fish are real, real fussy. And now we're gonna rig up a float rod. I got a float rod here, but I'm gonna put a smaller bobber on and just make it a little more finesse. Oh, someone's calling. Hello? Hey buddy, how's it going? Oh, we got about 2 hours yet till it starts. I'm feeling good. I think, I mean, I didn't catch lots of fish in pre-fish, but they were big, so. Really? I guess so. I didn't really plan for it. Are you sure? Yeah, okay, no, I'm not afraid. You're afraid. All right, well, it starts at 12. Check in at 2 and 4, 9 hours. You don't have a chance, but I mean, you could try. All right, I'll send you a message. Give you all the rules. All right, buddy. Talk to you soon. No longer Jay versus Clay. It is Jay versus Clay versus Aaron. Weeb, Uncut Angling is joining the competition. Unbelievable. I thought I had a good shot against Clayton. Aaron is a stick. He is good. I'd made comments. I said, do you want to join a Jay versus Clay? And he never really said anything. And all of a sudden this morning he decides that he wants to do it. He's probably headed to Lake Winnipeg, which makes this a lot tougher. Not that Clayton doesn't catch giants, but Lake Winnipeg has been cranking out a lot of big fish lately. Here we go. This is the first, I don't know if this is many. Aaron told me that it's gonna be tied after today, which means that Clayton and I are gonna stay tied 2-2 and Aaron's gonna get a win. He's coming from behind, but it should be good. If you've not heard of Aaron Weeb, Uncut Angling, you've been living under a rock. This is gonna be good. All the videos will be linked below when we're done so you can see their side of the competition. I got a little more rigging to do. Just gotta rig up this slip float and we're gonna take off. Get ready. I don't wanna be blasting off at noon. We can be at the fishing spot for noon ready to drop down. So that's what I'm gonna do. We will see you guys very soon. All right, guys, we made it to our starting locale. There is some breeze and it's the same direction as yesterday, so I'm happy about that. If you guys haven't watched the pre-fish video, I'll link it below. I crushed them in pre-fish. I overfished them, which is like the biggest thing that you don't want to do during pre-fish, but I don't really have an excuse. I was just greedy. And I was like, well, this may be the best walleye fishing I ever see. So I caught as many as I could. When I left, there was still some fish swimming around, so I need 5 today. I only caught like 7 or 8 walleyes yesterday, but I think we're gonna maybe change techniques a little bit, maybe do some slip floating and try to keep away from the fish. But we got 10 minutes to spare. I'm gonna set up cameras, make sure everything's dialed, get leeches rigged, and then I'm just gonna do some driving and yeah, get ready to take the first cast at 12 o'clock. It is currently 11:48. We got cloud cover, we got the perfect wind. Things are looking good. We're gonna need 5 big ones. I think it's gonna take 27-inch average, maybe. It's gonna take some big fish. We're coming up to the juice, the spot on the spot. This area that we're fishing is a pinch point with a sand flat. There's weeds on the top, and I was catching them just off the edge. They might be moved up in the weeds, it being a bit sunnier, but that kind of looked fishy off to the right. Now we're into the weeds. I don't want to just blow right in here. I want to like just take my time. Okay, that might be another fish. That's definitely a fish. That's definitely a fish. Oh my goodness. I need to use my phone to show you. Oh my goodness. Look at that school of fish. Look at all those fish off to the right. I will spend 9 hours here if I need to. I'm not afraid. The consistent winds are key. When you're dealing with wind, you know, you can get caught up in what the wind is that day, but it's like the wind from the day before and the day before that. They always say fish yesterday's winds, you know? And we've had consistent wind now in the same direction, hitting the shelf. And I think it's been, you know, stacking up the fish. It is 12 o'clock. Welcome to Clay versus Jay versus Aaron. Here we go. Bobbers are floating. Well, this is relaxing. I wonder how the other guys are doing. So if your bobber sits sideways, that means that you haven't set too deep with a slip float. You want it to go straight up and down. That means the weights are pulling it down. There's a fish. There's a suspended fish cruising. Come on. It looked like he kind of went down at it. Oh, all the bait just got spooked away. Oh yeah, here we go. Here we go. Come on. He's staring at it. This is good. This is gonna be our first bite. Oh, he's all over it. There's 2 of them. There's 3 of them. Oh, come on. The other guy one's coming down. He's staring at it. Eat it. Come on. Every bite is just so key. They disappeared, but I think they might still be around. Oh, no. You're kidding me, I just marked the mega school. And I got my leeches tangled together. Unreal. I'm not good under pressure. I'm gonna have a mental breakdown. This is not my day right now. Okay, I see them. Wow, they're there 65 feet ahead. Is that gonna be too shallow? No, that's gonna be perfect. I don't know if I made it far enough. Where's my bobber? Where's my bobber? We're hooked up. We're hooked up. It feels good. First fish of the day on the slip float. I saw those fish on Savaging, thought I blew my chance. Doesn't feel huge, but hopefully it's a walleye. Okay, it's feeling bigger now. Unreal, there's one following it. I've never seen that before. There's another one the same size, maybe bigger, following him up. Wow. All right, first fish, not big. All right, let's show you what we're dealing with. Nice chunky fish, nothing wrong with that. Throwing it on the bump board here. Mouth closed, 22 we'll call it. All right, the walleye's around. Jumbo leech or jumbo walleye? All right, all right, all right, all right. One on the board, guys. 22 incher. We've been fishing for 1 hour. Check in. Is it 2 o'clock? It is now 1 o'clock. We've got 22 inches. Not great, but I'm just happy that there's fish around. I thought these conditions, they might be completely gone. Middle of the day, flat calm. Not much for cloud. Crystal clear lake. Need any more excuses? And I caught them all yesterday. I know, you guys are like, Jay, you're such an idiot. You deserve to lose. I know, I know, I know, I know. I'm fine with that. There's another fish. Is at the top of a weed. I don't know, 60 feet. Bobber down. Yes. Ooh. Ooh. Okay. Feels a little squirrely. Nice walleye. We're gonna take it. These conditions. That's bigger than the last one. The bobber just barely went down. Get in here. That's a nice fish. Once again, hopefully we don't need it for our top five, but I just want to have some fish for the check-in. That is a nice, stocky fish right there. So good. All right, let's throw them on the bump. If you guys are looking for a bump board, I highly recommend Musky Bumper. They did the bump boards for 39 hours. All right, mouth closed. 26 inches. Nice, that's good. Not gonna lie, after yesterday, they all kind of have looked small so far. So this is a 7'6" medium light. And basically how a slip float works. So I've got this little piece of yarn further up my line. You can't see it right now. And the bobber will float up until it hits that yarn. I got a bunch of split shot there, way too much. And then a little octopus hook with a yummy, yummy leech. So that's good. We got two. That was kind of on a new spot, a little further off. And I saw one individual fish and we were able to catch him. So I'm assuming we caught that fish. Maybe it's a different one. Here we go. Ooh. This feels big. Come on. Come on. I'm gonna spot lock us. I just marked one fish on Sat Imaging. Not Sat Imaging, live scope. Off the nose and I cast a drop shot at him and boom, just thumped it. It just, I haven't lifted it yet. Oh, I'm nervous. I can barely lift this fish. Ooh, ooh, those are big head shakes. I think it's a walleye. Come on. Come up to the top. Yes, that's a better one. That might be a keeper. Oh, there we go. All right, let's measure him first. Chesty's rolling. I'm gonna say 26 maybe, maybe a little longer. All right, 27 and a half, going to the head, touching. Let's hold this up. 27 and a half, 26, and a 24. Look at that big starchy golden Manitou weather station. Voila. First one on the drop shot. Drop shot was perfect in that situation because I marked the fish 60 feet in front of me with live scope, and I wanted something to get down quick. The slip float takes a little bit longer, and that, you know, sometimes you only have a quick moment before maybe that fish spooks or you float over it. So, feeling good.
Ooh, big one, big one, big one, big one, big one. Two of them, three. There's a pod. I'm gonna try split shot and leech next if this doesn't happen. Oh, bad. Loose drag, loose drag, but we're hooked up. Oh, and I'm off. I gotta check in. I'm putting this down while I check in. There's just a, it's a shark tank down there. All right, Clayton and Aaron. First period was medium, but considering the conditions, it's flat calm, all my excuses, I'm feeling good. Got 75.5 inches, and this is just the beginning. I'd be afraid. I'd be very afraid. Hope you guys are having fun. Miss you. Holla, 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 holla. We making noise. We're out here on Big Windy, as you can see. Yikes, hey? We basically caught nothing the whole time, and I was trying to fish deep, and I pulled up right against the bank, made three casts and caught 54. Yeah, there's your hint. Leaves you not really knowing if that's a 32 and a 22 or a 35 and a 29 and a 19. Shoot, maths. Look at her, fast asleep. And we're coming for you! Aaron has 54 inches. Says, look freaking out. We don't play nice with your types. That's good, that's good. Aaron didn't pre-fish at all, so I mean, He's got some work to do. I'm excited, guys. What I'm seeing swimming underneath the boat right now is just absolute madness. All right, we got another notification.
Well, boys, I'm just waiting for your first check-in, but here's my video for you guys, Aaron and Jay. I know we're not telling each other how many fish we have currently, so I'll just say this. I have 82 and a half inches of fish. I have an absolute disaster in the boat, rods everywhere. I've got GoPro head camera, keeps overheating. Trolling motor remote quit. I got pike breaking me off. I have been sight fishing walleye though, which has been unreal. Like literally watching fish swim in the shallows, casting to them, catching them. But I'm 34 degrees Celsius. I'm cooking, it's hot. I hope you guys had a good period. I'm pretty sure you did, I would say. You're probably crushing me, but yes, 82. I'm checking in with 82 and a half inches of walleye. Good luck in the next period, gentlemen.
Clayton's got 82.5. Clayton is in the lead after the first check-in. He's definitely caught his five. Aaron and I have not, well, I'm assuming Aaron hasn't. Just a boy and a bobber. I got all day walleyes. This is one of the situations where it's like, we have found them. We are on the spot. There are so many fish around. And now it's fine tuning the presentation, making it as finesse as possible, lighter lines, smaller hooks, all that stuff that maybe isn't the most fun. You know, I'd rather be throwing a swim bait, but if that's gonna get me bites, if that's gonna win me this prestigious tournament, then I'll do it, right? So, slip floating is fun. Drop shotting is fun, don't get me wrong, but like ripping a blade bait over the weed sounds pretty fun. What is that? A muskie just porpoised. Did you see that? That was a muskie. I hope I don't hook him. Remember the pike? Getting pike-eyed? We just got muskie-eyed. Straight off the nose right now. That wasn't a great cast. Oh, had a bite. Yeah, we're hooked up. We're hooked up. Feels good. I'm gonna turn spot lock off. Big head shakes. Ooh, drag's a bit tight. Feeling big. Feeling big. It's medium. It's okay. Still gonna have a pretty good five fish if we can land this fish. This is only number four. Ooh, that's a nice fish. That's better than I thought, actually. 24 and a quarter, you guys got that? And touching, mouth closed over there. 24 and a quarter. Bye, buddy. Okay, they're right ahead, 45 feet.
There's the pod. I'm gonna try to back off of them. Under. Oh, I lost him. My drag was so loose too. He got my leech. Oh, guys, that was number five. One of these fish. One of these fish. Let's get the fifth right before the last check-in. Ooh, this guy looks like he's coming for it. He's big too. Yes, that was a bad hook set. Oh, my drag was so loose. Come on, baby, right before the check-in. Decent. I mean, they're all decent. Definitely not the kicker we're looking for yet. All right, number five, just before check-in. We worked. Let's throw them on the board. 21 and a quarter. Boom. You go. Guys, I've been playing nice. But that's all done now. I'm calling out all my fish last period, so this number doesn't mean anything, but I'm at 121. I hope you guys crack them. Yeah, I hope we all crack them. I just hope I crack them a little bit better.
We're good. Things are good. Relax. Everything's good. Everything's good. So, what do we got? 101.25. We're going to be in the lead if nobody's upgraded. Okay. We still have 5 hours left. There's lots of time. I'm not concerned in the slightest. I will say this. We do not play nice with your pipes.
Well, boys, 401. Here's my update video for you guys. Things are meh, very medium. I've caught one fish that has gone towards my total to put me at 103 and a quarter. 103 and a quarter or 103 and 75. Either way, whatever it is, I'll text you the correct number, but it's one of those numbers that's right here. 103 and a quarter, I believe. Tough days. I'm hoping for some wind. I just got a breeze just starting to pick up. Anyways, I hope you boys are having a great day because that's all that really matters. Bye, guys.
Oh, bobber down. We're hooked up. Feeling big. Feeling real big. Okay, I'm gonna chase him with the trolling motor. We got a big one. Oh, these tiny hooks just make me so nervous. I think that's the biggest one of the day. Yes, baby. That's gonna be, yep, probably the biggest of the day. That is a hog. Wow, sorry, I was kind of quiet there. Just like, tournaments are highs and lows. Highs and lows all the time. Oh, that hook just popped out. Okay, that's a big fish. 28 and three quarters going to the head. I'll close the mouth a little better. There we go. Yeah, 28 and a half, mouth closed. Yes, baby. Guys, that is what we were waiting for. Camping out paid off. 28 and a half. That is a good upgrade.
That is a big fish.
Hiya. That's what we needed. That is gonna be a big call. I'm nowhere close to confident yet though. Like, you've seen it. Comebacks in the last period definitely happen. And Aaron being on Lake Winnipeg, there's just been crazy statistics of big fish. So, yeah, I got no expectations.
Bobber's under. Oh.
Yes.
Oh, 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 oh. He is right under the boat. Okay, he's big. Thought he was a lake trout out there. If I hadn't seen that white tip on the tail.
This is the best fight yet. I hate how he's just always under the boat. It's like he knows that's safety.
That's a big one. Oh, yes.
He's short and thick. I don't think he'll be that long. All right, 26 over there. Just barely touching. The white part actually goes across further. And then closed mouth. 26 incher. That's a nice upgrade.
Well, guys, I got some bad news. Turns out my main camera didn't save a couple clips properly when the batteries died. Normally that's just a thing, but something to do with these different battery packs I was using didn't save it properly. So I think I lost like probably half the footage from today, from the main camera. So there's chesty stuff, but my apologies. I'd never had that happen before, but it didn't recover the clips. Oh, that is frustrating. Okay, well, things are good now. We're gonna finish strong. I'm gonna call it all those fish, so that footage won't matter anyways. I hope. Yes, we are hooked up. I think things are gonna turn on. Ah, it's just a little guy. Good sign though, good sign. I had the camera off for a while and had two fish crews under the boat and this guy just charged at it. His mood was much different than the other fish today, so hopefully that's a sign of things to come. Just so lightly hooked. All right. Sun is starting to get low and we are catching nice walleyes, probably 23, 24 incher. Going right back, because that's not an upgrade. I need 24 and a quarter is an upgrade. Maybe I should have measured that. There's a fish. Just don't know where my leech is. Look at those fish on the right coming towards my leech right there. Fish from either side, there's three of them. I should watch my bobber. The leech is just kicking, he's nervous. Actually, the bobber tapping from the leech. Oh, it just went under. Wow, that was weird. Another smaller guy. Even this, even like one of the smallest ones we've caught today. Look at this guy, he's missing an eye. He's too big to eat. This is one eye Wally right there, if I ever did see him. All right, see ya baby. So you might be asking, Jay, why did you spend all day in the exact same spot? Well, yesterday, I'll link the video below, I crushed them in this area. It's a neck down, a pinch point. So right away, that's a traffic spot for fish. And this spot had enough complexities to it, it being a pinch point. There was some shallow sand, deeper sand, weed beds. And even though I caught them in a new place today, I had a feeling that they wouldn't go too far from yesterday. So we found them, I don't know, 400 yards from where we caught them yesterday, 300 yards maybe. So still in the vicinity. And I just knew it was gonna be a matter of driving around and trusting my electronics and looking between side imaging and live scope. The fish can't hide. They can hide in the weeds decently when they're a little bit deeper, but like if they're a little bit off bottom, they show up pretty good. So I mean, I saw those fish on this deep weed bed, whatever, 6 hours ago, and maybe 5 hours ago, and that's where we ended up spending like two-thirds of the day on this very weed bed. Still been moving around and stuff, but like the fish are going to be moving, their moods are going to be changing throughout the day, and if you're confident that it's a potentially winning spot if you're in a derby. I'm not saying this is a winning spot. I don't know. For all I know, Aaron's got 530 interest right now. Or Clayton's lit it up. I'm not sure. I still would like to get a couple more big bites. But yeah, for me, just hunkering down and camping on my best spot. So otherwise, you can get caught up second guessing yourself and running around. And I've been in that situation so many times. And there's a lot of bait surfacing. Anyways, hopefully this bobber goes down once or twice more. We have an hour left, 1 hour remaining in Jay versus Clay versus Aaron. Well guys, time is up. That is it. Our total, I always get these calculations wrong at the end, I think was 132.25, which is an average of 132.25 divided by 5. That's a 26, almost 26 and a half inch average. This is what did most of the damage. 7'6", slip float, split shot, big greasy leech on the bottom. I was using 10 pound mono. Could use fluoro, I'm sure. But that's what put most of the fish in the boat, as well as drop shotting a couple. Yesterday we were catching our fish in 17 feet of water on a ledge where the wind was hitting, and today they were right in the weeds, right in the thickest weeds I could find in 14 feet of water, cruising around, being weird, being super fussy. But we got enough to bite to put together an impressive bag. Like I said, not a numbers fishery by any means. I mean, I put the trolling motor down and I didn't lift it all day, 9 hours in the same vicinity. And we camped out and we got some good bites. I hope Clayton and Aaron had a good finish of the day. Anything's possible. They definitely could have won. They're both on phenomenal walleye lakes. I think that's all I gotta say. Shout out to Manitou Weather Station Lodge for hosting us. I will link them below. Sorry about the technical difficulties with the camera today. Hopefully GoPro captured most of it, whatever this camera didn't capture. Don't forget to wear your life jacket. Thank you guys for watching, and we got one more day at Manitou, and then we're headed home tomorrow.